Hello, my name's Simon Crafer, and I'm still in Austria, still at the Red Bull Ring, and it's time for this week's Tech Talk. The last couple of days have been the most exciting since my children were born, without exaggeration. If you watch to the end of this live, you'll understand why. Last Wednesday, a couple of days ago, I went to the KTM factory, and it was more modern and bigger than I expected. And we don't have time right now for me to tell you everything I saw there, but I'm going to tell you the two highlights, which were going to where they make the chassis. I saw the latest chassis in the jig, not yet welded up, and got to ask questions from the man who makes these chassis, designs them. He's an ex-rider himself, and he's been with KTM since the very beginning, Wolfgang Felbe. And Wolfgang, for me, was an absolute pleasure to meet. He's one of those guys like Guy Coulon or Merlin Plumley that I worked with, who have not only incredible knowledge, and they have a passion still, and they're so enthusiastic. You know, I got to ask him all these questions. It was truly amazing. And the other highlight was going to the engine area, where I got to see the latest MotoGP engine on the dyno while talking to Kurt Trieb, who is their KTM's engine designer. He designed the MotoGP engine, but he also designed Moto3 and many other engines for KTM. He's an absolute gentleman, real pleasure for me to meet. And I didn't understand at the beginning why I was so emotional seeing the engine on the dyno. I'll tell you what happened. They have a simulation program, and they put in Miguel Oliveira's laps from the last MotoGP race at Mugello. So I'm sitting there watching this engine going through the laps, you know. It's like, to give you an idea, it's like, then, you see this thing going through there, and I was doing my best not to cry, and I didn't understand why, till I realized the only time you hear an engine working like that is if you're a high level rider. And I hadn't heard that for like 20 years, you know. It was something amazing. And I could literally pick where exactly it was on circuit. It was mind blowing. So anyway, I got to ask Kurt all questions about the engine. Truly amazing. Then Thursday, yesterday, I got to do this.
taking the mickey out of me.
Also, for a memory, oh. The top of the...
Oh, man. Okay. Thank you, mate. Yeah. I really appreciate it. Take care of you.
That, for me, was a dream come true. It was my first ever experience on a four-stroke GP bike. And let me run through what it felt like. Leaving the pit box, I felt like a bit of a learner driver. It was like, out of the... Because the engine doesn't want to run at a low RPM if you try to go. As soon as I got the RPM up a bit, it smoothed all out. Up the hill, through turn two, it was... The first impression is phenomenal fast, but the big impression was gearbox. Truly beautiful, maybe the most beautiful thing on the bike. For example, it's like an electric engine feeling. There's no cut, there's no jolt for when the next gear comes in. It's seamless, like the name, like the gearbox is called. Absolutely beautiful. You hear the engine RPM change, but you feel no gap, truly amazing. So super fast going up through turn two. Brakes, I realized I hadn't warmed them up enough. And my experience from the late 90s with carbons is the brake lever feels like it's welded to the bar. When you grab it, there's nothing, no friction at all. You think, oh, not even any brake lines, you know? One, two, three, and violently grab. These, even though I hadn't warmed them up, it was less than half that time to get warm, and I didn't get in trouble because of it, you know? Got away with that. And they're so predictable, beautiful. Like, they've come a long way, the carbon brakes. So I got the bike stopped in first gear. It all matches all the RPM, it's beautiful. Turn in, you actually have to stop it and turn it in, but coming out, on the initial throttle, I'm used to bikes that, all through my career, that have nasty torque. It's why I had 7 high sides in 3.5 months when I got on big bikes. Because in the low gears, there's too much torque. And this was just beautiful. Like, and after lap after lap, after coming off the first gear corners, I realized that it didn't matter exactly where I had the throttle. The bike managed it. I'm sure there's maps that put control more into the rider's hands and there's more danger, but this felt like literally you'd come off the corner, I'd go, and the front wheel would hover, and you'd go through that beautiful gearbox with the front wheel hovering off the ground, and it felt like the bike was doing it, really. It was gorgeous. Then it obviously has to hold back the power because there's too much power. When you get to fourth gear, it really goes. That's when I felt it pulls like a train, like the fastest machine I've ever been on or in anything. So I suppose to round up everything else, it's just so refined, meaning suspension so nice, handling so nice, it does everything beautifully. All I can say is a massive thank you to Pit Byra, Mike Leitner, and the whole KTM family for this incredible experience.